Hey, how you doing? This is Emilio here. In this video, we're going to show you how to hide files and folders on your Mac so that you can guarantee more privacy when you're browsing your Mac and when others are using your Mac. As always, this video is brought to you by Moonlock, where we do cybersecurity technology for humans. And also, hey, if you like what we're releasing, we'd love it if you also subscribe to our channel so you don't miss out on anything. Click on the button and on the bell so you are notified when we release new videos. Now, I'm going to be demoing this on macOS Sequoia. Now, we'll note that macOS Sequoia have changed the way to actually hide files, or at least some of the features have been removed. So earlier versions of macOS will be able to show you this method. Under the Hide These folder, under here, I've got a whole bunch of files and folders, okay? Now, in the olden days, all you needed to do was go in, select a file, and at the very start of a file, you just put in a period or a full stop, and you clicked on enter. But nowadays, on macOS Sequoia, you're now thrown up this warning. So if you're running an earlier version of macOS, this feature will still work for you. The modern version of macOS Sequoia and other versions of macOS, the easiest way to go and hide a file is to open up your terminal window. You can search for this by going into the spotlight and selecting terminal. Now, terminal is an easy way to go and navigate through your Mac using Unix commands because macOS is essentially running on Unix. You can actually go and path all these commands directly through within here. So you're gonna use a change directory command. You can do a mkrdir, which is a make directory command. What we're gonna do is we're gonna go and navigate to this particular path using our terminal. The easiest way is to go and do a change directory, and you can either type in manually the entire path, or I can just drag that in right over here. You'll see that the entire path will be listed, and I click on enter. I'm now located in the hide these folder. I can click on ls to go and see a list of all of the files that are located in here, and there they all are. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go and hide this particular file over here, and the easiest way to do this is to throw in this command. chflags hidden, and then drag in the file itself, or type it in manually, and enter. You'll now notice that that file is now gone. I'm gonna go and do the same thing for a whole bunch more. So I can now drag in another file, or if I know the name of it, gopro.png, I can just type that right in there. And that file is now hidden. I can now do an ls, and there are the files. You'll notice that those files are actually still there, but they're not visible from within my Finder. Now, to actually see hidden files within your Finder, grab your keyboard, and you're gonna type in Command Shift full stop or Command Shift period, and there are my files. There are the three files that I've actually now hidden. You'll notice that they're a little bit grayed out because they are hidden. To go and hide the files again, Command Shift and period, and now those files are again hidden. I can also go and hide the entire folder. I can do a change directory, go back one step. Running an ls command, you can see that this folder, hide these, is listed over here. You'll also notice that recycle bin is also there. However, it's not visible on here. Neither is desktop.ini, and that's because those files are hidden. They are seen within the terminal window, but not within the Finder. So let's say I want to go and hide these. This is the folder I want to hide. I can do the same command. Enter, and now that is now gone. Again, Command Shift period. I can now see those files that are hidden. To now unhide those particular files and folders, back into here, the same command, and I can now say no hidden, and then hide these and enter, and that folder will now be reappeared. There it is. Same deal with some of those files. Change directory, hide these, ls. These are the files that I don't want to be hidden anymore. Same command, GoPro, and that one right over here. And now those files are relisted over here. And you'll notice that clicking on Command Shift Plus, I can see some of those other files that are still hidden. Now, there are other applications that you can actually use to actually hide and unhide files, but that is the easiest way to do it here on our macOS. So there you have it. Thanks so much for tuning in. Remember to comment down below. Let us know what you thought. Give us a thumbs up, a like if you enjoyed this video. And if you don't want to miss out on any of our future video releases, remember to click on that subscription button and on that bell. Thanks so much for tuning in. We'll see you on the next video.